हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ज्योग्राफी क्लास। टुडे विल डिस्कस चैप्टर 17, कंपोजिशन एंड स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द एटमॉस्फेयर। टुडे विल स्टडी पेज नंबर 243 टू पेज 246। प्लीज ओपन चैप्टर 17 एट पेज 243। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस सी द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ द चैप्टर। नंबर वन, composition of atmosphere. Number two, we'll discuss the structure of the atmosphere. Number three, importance of the atmosphere. Number four, ozone depletion, ozone layer, depletion of ozone layer, ozone hole, effects of ozone layer depletion, and safeguards against the ozone layer depletion. The objectives of today's class are as follows. Number one, the composition of atmosphere. Number two, the composition of dry air. Number three, uses of important gases like nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, hydrogen and ozone. Number four, we'll discuss the uses of water vapor and dust particles. And at last, we'll discuss the structure of the atmosphere. Our Earth is surrounded by atmosphere. The atmosphere of the Earth is a layer of gases commonly known as air that remains around the Earth due to the gravity of the Earth. Earth's atmosphere is about 300 miles or about 480 kilometers thick. Earth's atmosphere is similar to a jacket for our planet. It keeps us warm, gives us oxygen to breathe, and it is the place where all the weather phenomena take place. Let us go through the technical terms that are coming in today's topic. Number one, atmosphere. The thick blanket of air that surrounds the Earth from all sides is called atmosphere. Number two, gravitational force, the force that attracts two objects towards each other. Number three, reflection of light, when a ray of light approaches a smooth polished surface like a mirror, the ray of the light bounces back or it is sent back by the mirror. This is called reflection of light. Meteorology. The study of weather, that is the study of day-to-day changes in the Earth's atmosphere on local or regional level, is called meteorology. Solar radiation. The heat and light emitted by the sun is called solar radiation. It is also called as electromagnetic energy or electromagnetic radiation. Insolation. The solar energy that reaches the Earth's surface and Earth's atmosphere is called insolation, or we can say the solar energy which is trapped by the Earth and its atmosphere is called insolation. Terrestrial radiation. The amount of heat reflected by the Earth, mostly at night, is called terrestrial radiation. Next term is greenhouse effect. The process in which the Earth's atmosphere traps radiation emitted by the sun and by the Earth. Carbon dioxide, water vapor, methane are some important greenhouse gases. These gases keep the Earth warmer by trapping the heat coming from the sun and radiated back by the Earth. Ultraviolet radiation. The portion of electromagnetic radiation, that is solar radiation, between X-rays and visible light. The sun is a source of alpha rays, beta rays, gamma rays, X-rays, infrared rays and even ultraviolet rays. Tropics. The region of the Earth along the equator and between Tropic of Cancer, that is 23.5 degree north latitude, and Tropic of Capricorn, that is 23.5 degree south latitude, is called tropic. Pollen. A fine powdery substance, typically yellow in color, produced by flowers. Meteor. A piece of rock from the space that produces a bright light as it travels through the atmosphere. They are called Turta Tara in Hindi. Temperate areas. The areas between Tropic of Cancer, that is 23.5 degree north, and Arctic Circle, that is 66.5 degree north in the Northern Hemisphere, and Tropic of Capricorn, that is 23.5 degree south, and Antarctic Circle, that is 66.5 degree south in the Southern Hemisphere. Means temperate areas lie between tropical areas and frigid areas. Convection current or convection air current. the vertical movement of air from the earth to atmosphere and from atmosphere to the earth is called convection current or convectional air current. Hydroscopic nuclei. Microscopic particles like sulfur dioxide, salt, dust or smoke in the air on which water vapor condenses to form water droplets or to form clouds. Condensation. The process by which water vapor in the atmosphere cools and changes into water. Cloud. Cloud is a visible mass of condensed water vapor floating in the atmosphere. Optical phenomena. Any observable event that results from interaction of light and matter. Example is rainbow. We can see in rainbow, we can observe the light, seven colors in the light. Dawn, the time of the day when light first appears in the sky, means it is the time before the sunrise. Dusk, dusk is the time before night when it is not yet dark. It is also called twilight. Now we will discuss the terms related to the layers of atmosphere. Here is a diagram that shows the different layers of the atmosphere. The first layer is troposphere. Next layer, stratosphere. Stratosphere is followed by mesosphere. The fourth layer is thermosphere or ionosphere. And the last layer is exosphere. Let us see their definitions. Troposphere. The lowermost layer of the atmosphere is called troposphere, as we have seen in the diagram. Tropopause is the uppermost limit of troposphere. Normal lapse rate. The temperature decreases with height roughly at the rate of 1 degree Celsius for every 165 meter of height or 6.4 degree Celsius for 1 kilometer of height. It means that as we go high in the atmosphere, the temperature decreases with height. Stratosphere. The second layer of the atmosphere that lies above the troposphere is called stratosphere. Stratopause. The uppermost limit of stratosphere is termed as stratopause. Ozonosphere. The lower part of the stratosphere having maximum concentration of ozone gas is called ozonosphere. Mesosphere. The third layer of atmosphere that lies above the stratosphere is called mesosphere. Mesopause. The uppermost layer of mesosphere is termed as mesopause. Ionosphere. The layer of atmosphere above mesosphere, which has ions, are called ionosphere. Ions. Ions are electrically charged particles. Last term is exosphere. The uppermost layer of the atmosphere extending beyond the ionosphere is called exosphere. Now, let us read the chapter from page 243 in your book. The vast expanse of air which envelops the earth all round is called atmosphere. The air of the atmosphere has become an integral part, means inseparable part of the earth due to earth's gravitational force. According to F.J. Monkhouse, the atmosphere is a thin layer of gas held to the earth by gravitational attraction. According to H.J. Crutchfield, the atmosphere is a deep blanket of gases which entirely envelops the earth. The air in the atmosphere is colorless, odorless and tasteless. Odorless means it has no smell. Means the gases have no smell or the air has no smell. We cannot feel the presence of air unless it blows as wind. There are differences in the opinion regarding the thickness of the atmosphere. Some scientists believe that the atmosphere is 4500 km in height. Previously, it was considered to be 800 km. But latest discoveries hint that the atmosphere is about 32,000 km thick. Now, we will study about the composition of atmosphere. The atmosphere is composed of gases, water vapor and dust particles. The important gases in the atmosphere are nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, hydrogen, ozone, etc. 2% of the atmosphere is composed of water vapor. Water vapor decreases with altitude and with latitude. It means that as we go high in the atmosphere, the water vapor decreases, and as we move away from equator to poles, the water vapor decreases. Water vapor and dust particle together form clouds, which we will study in detail in the further classes. If we talk about the composition of dry air contains 78% of nitrogen, 21% of oxygen, 0.93% of argon, 0.04% of carbon dioxide, and other gases, they are less than 1% in the dry air. Now we'll discuss about the importance of various gases, water vapor, and dust particles in the atmosphere. Please open your book at page 244. First of all, we'll discuss about the importance of nitrogen. Nitrogen accounts for about 78% of the total volume of the atmosphere. The atmospheric pressure, force of the wind, reflection of light is largely due to nitrogen. This gas has no color, no odor, odor means smell, or no taste. Nitrogen avoids quick burning, so it would be difficult to control fire in the absence of nitrogen. Nitrogen, it generates protein for the plants, which is the main source of food. This gas is found up to the height of 128 km in the atmosphere. Oxygen. Oxygen accounts for about 21% of the total volume of the atmosphere. Oxygen is called life giver because it is very essential for breathing. All the living beings, including human beings, intake oxygen and release carbon dioxide. Oxygen helps in burning of fuel. It is a main source of energy and provides solid base for industries. It extends up to 64 km of the atmosphere. Carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide accounts for about 0.04% of the total volume of the atmosphere. Carbon dioxide is the heaviest gas and is confined to lower layers only, although it can be found up to the height of 32 km, but in very small quantity. Carbon dioxide is most essential gas for growth of the plant. It is also important for the study of weather and climate, that is called meteorology, because carbon dioxide absorbs the radiation coming from the sun and the radiation which is released by the earth, called terrestrial radiation. So it keeps the earth warmer at all the time. This process we have discussed is also called greenhouse effect. The amount of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is increasing due to burning of fossil fuels like coal, petroleum and natural gas. It has increased the temperature of the atmosphere. Ozone. As we have discussed earlier, ozone is found in small quantity in the stratosphere. It is a special variety of oxygen which saves us from the harmful ultraviolet radiations coming from the sun. It is mainly found at the height of 10 to 50 km above the earth's surface. Now, let us discuss about the importance of water vapor. Water vapor accounts for about 2% of the atmosphere by volume. Water vapor is more in the warm and wet tropics, where it can be about 4%. But in the dry and cold areas of deserts and polar regions, the amount of water vapor is very less. It can be less than 1%. The amount of water vapor decreases with altitude. It is estimated that half the water vapor in the air lies below the altitude of about 2000 meters. It also decreases from equator towards pole. Water vapor absorbs a large part of the insulation. Insulation is the heat which is absorbed by the earth from the sun and reduces its amount reaching the earth's surface. It also preserves the earth radiated heat. Thus, it acts as a blanket, allowing the earth neither to become too cold nor to become too hot. Now, let us see how important are the dust particles? When air blows as wind with sufficient speed, it carries large quantities of dust particles and keep them suspended in the air. They are derived from different sources and includes sea salt, fine soil, smoke soot, ash, pollen from flowers, dust, and disintegrated particles of meteors. Dust particles are mostly found in the lower layers of the atmosphere, but it can be carried to a great height by convectional air current. The amount of dust particles is more in the subtropical and temperate areas because of dry and windy conditions than the equatorial and polar regions. It means that equatorial region and polar regions have less dust particles. These dust particles are very important for weather and climate, or we can say for meteorology. Many of them act as hygroscopic nuclei. It means that the water vapor which reaches the atmosphere, they cling, they are absorbed by the dust particles and they form the hygroscopic nuclei for forming the raindrops or water drops. Thus, dust particles help in the formation of cloud. Dust particles also intercept, means absorb, and reflect insulation. Dust in the air produces marvelous optical phenomena of red and orange hues. Hues means color. We can see that the sky is sometime red in color, sometime it seems to be orange in color, mostly at the time of sunrise and sunset, which are also called as dawn, that is the time before the sunrise, and dusk, the time after the sunset. Besides, dense haze and smog are also caused due to the presence of dust particles in the atmosphere. Sky looks blue in color due to the presence of dust particles in the atmosphere. Now we will study the structure of atmosphere in detail with the help of this diagram. In this diagram, we can see that the atmosphere is divided into five layers: troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, ionosphere or thermosphere, and at last exosphere. Let us discuss troposphere first. Troposphere is the lowermost layer of the atmosphere. Its average height is 16 km. It is 8 km in height at poles and 18 km at equator. It is the most important layer of atmosphere because it contains the important gases like oxygen, carbon dioxide, etc. All the weather phenomena, that is cloud formation, lightning, thunderstorm, rainfall, cyclones, anticyclones, all these weather phenomena take place in this layer. In troposphere, as we move up, the temperature decreases. We have discussed the normal lapse rate, that after every 165 meter of height, the temperature decreases by 1 degree Celsius. Now, tropopause. Tropopause is the uppermost limit of troposphere, means it is a boundary between stratosphere and troposphere. After troposphere, the weather changes stop. Stratosphere. Stratosphere, it extends from 30 to 50 km. If we take the upper part, it starts from 18 km and extends up to 50 km. Stratosphere has large amount of ozone in its lower part. From 15 to 35 km, we can see dense concentration of ozone gas, which is very vital gas, very important gas for us, because ozone, it prevent or protect us from ultraviolet rays coming from the sun. Ultraviolet rays are very, very intense rays, very hot rays, which can cause many problems on the earth. We'll discuss about ozone and its importance in the further classes. Stratosphere, in this layer, aeroplanes, they fly. The weather balloons, they are launched. Because stratosphere is free from cloud, free from weather phenomena. So it is ideal for flying aeroplanes, jet aircraft, and even for launching the weather satellites. The third layer is mesosphere. Mesosphere, its height is from 50 km to 80 km. In mesosphere, the temperature increases because in this layer, as the meteors they enter, they burn in this layer. So here the temperature is little high. The boundary between mesosphere and stratosphere is called stratopause. In stratosphere, as we have discussed in troposphere, the temperature was decreasing, but in stratosphere the temperature increases with height because it has ozone gas which is trapping the ultraviolet rays, which are very very hot. The next layer is thermosphere or ionosphere. Ionosphere has ions, which are electrically charged particles, which are very important for radio broadcasting. The radio waves which are sent from the earth, they are deflected back by the ions present in the ionosphere. So ionosphere is very important for radio broadcasting. The last layer is exosphere. The height of exosphere is actually not known. We know very less about this layer. This layer has light gases like helium and hydrogen. With this, we complete our today's topic. Your homework is to read the given pages, to solve exercise second, question number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, and exercise second, question number 1 and 2. You must revise today's topic thoroughly. Thank you very much.